specifically about BringGo?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, or the whole system.
Okay. So if you look at this, what you're looking at is the one of the Chevy MyLink systems. It's available in both versions of the Chevy Spark and Chevrolet Sonic. In the Trax, the system, which is the vehicle that we're in, this system comes standard. It includes a 7-inch touchscreen that allows you to do different things like operate your telephone once you're connected via Bluetooth. And I can come back and do things like look at various pictures, movies off of a USB thumb drive. One of the other great things about this system is that it will also mirror apps off your phone. So you can see the standard audio apps that you kind of become commonplace across the lineup, like Pandora, Stitcher, TuneIn. And you'll notice that fourth icon is for an app called BringGo. BringGo is an app available at both iTunes and the Google Play stores. It's available for anyone to purchase. And once it's on your phone, the ability to display it onto the MyLink screen in a Chevrolet vehicle is proprietary to our system. You'll notice I've already got it launched on the phone, and simply by pressing the icon, I can pull up a fully functioning navigation system. So at the moment, the current app price is $50. It's a one-time fee. The application actually lives on your phone, so you're not accessing data as you use it, which is really convenient for limiting the amount of data that you would go through on your plan. You notice that you have single line entry, you can search for POI. These are all the kind of standards you would expect from a navigation system. Coming back into the actual map display, you can notice the resolution. It's pretty high. Zoom in, zoom out. You can really take a look at your surrounding environs. Come back, you can put in a route. Once you have a route programmed, it'll play through the stereo system in the car, giving you directions on when and where to turn. When you compare this against most factory installed systems, it's a fraction of the price, and even at $50, you think that's probably more inexpensive than most aftermarket systems. So really a neat way to be able to deliver a fully functioning navigation system at a very inexpensive price in a vehicle that starts at $21,000 for the Chevrolet Trax, or even if you look at something like the Chevrolet Spark, which starts at $13,000. Once you're at a certain trim level, the system comes into play and you can get that $50 app. If I take this and disconnect, the app comes with me. It lives on my phone, so I can use it as I walk around. If my friends have a Chevrolet vehicle but don't have the BringGo app, I can plug into their system and let the application play and utilize it. Really just kind of a neat and inexpensive solution. The other great thing about the Chevrolet MyLink system is that with the introduction of almost any Chevrolet vehicle for the 2015 model year, we've introduced embedded Wi-Fi hotspots in the car. So when you think about a vehicle like this with its ability to not only be in an urban setting, find easy parking, get great fuel economy, but also if you get out on the open road and do some weekend excursions, and you're out in the country and want to be able to get onto Wi-Fi, I can simply press the
OnStar ready
and ask for Wi-Fi settings.
157. Nope. Thank you. Goodbye.
All right, let's try that again. So if I press the button,
OnStar ready.
Wi-Fi settings.
Wi-Fi settings. Please see the owner's manual for information about your Wi-Fi hotspot settings.
And its own unique password.
Cancel. Returning to the main menu. OnStar ready.
Cancel.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Password protected network, because at this point, everyone will recognize as a Chevrolet vehicle rolls by that's 2015 or newer, almost every vehicle, that it has its own Wi-Fi network. And obviously, we don't want people siphoning off your signal.
Right.
So you can connect 7 devices at once, up to a 50-foot radius around the car, so long as the car is on. So it doesn't need to be running necessarily, as long as the key is in the on position.
Gotcha. Does that work through this too, the same button? Is it the same as this?
It's a dual function button, so gotcha. You can do either Siri eyes free, if you're familiar with that, or you can coordinate with the car's voice rec system.
Okay.
With the Siri Eyes Free system, if you're not familiar, really great option also available to the system, and most of our vehicles actually, that allows you to interact with your phone while your phone's safely out of your hand. So you can do things like check your calendar. You can ask for latest sports scores. There are certain applications that would require you to take your eyes off the road that Siri will not allow you to do. So I can ask what my appointments for the day are, and Siri will communicate those back to me. I can ask, you know, the game score, as I've mentioned, but I can't ask anything that would require a web browser to open, like, what is a whale?
Yeah.
Siri will tell me, sorry, you're driving currently, I won't do that for you.
Gotcha. Okay. All right, thank you. Let me pause.